Alright folks, we're going to be taking it to the small screen today with a game whose big brother arcade I'm sure you stuffed with pockets full of quarters. The game is called Elevator Action, and we're going to be taking a look at the Game Boy version, which actually looks like it might be a good contender to rival its arcade and NES brother. Going down, please. Well, if you've never played the original Elevator Action games, I might suggest shelling out a few bucks, or points, or whatever the hell is necessary to play it on the Wii Virtual Console. Yeah, I might suggest that if I gave a crap about the f***ing Virtual Console, just download MAME or a good NES emulator and play the bloody game, huh? If you're criticizing me to high heaven but still want to know what Elevator Action is all about, if you don't know, super. Basically, you're in control of Agent 17. Otherwise known as Auto. Not that Auto. Your mission is to recover top secret documents in each building, make your way to the basement, to your getaway car, and head on to the next building. Naturally, there are some people who don't want you taking their formula for Coca-Cola and the April 2002 edition of Playboy with Tiffany on the cover. Okay, moving right along. Yeah, these guys are here to stop you from taking the top secret documents, so they're ordered to shoot on sight, yada yada yada. To take them out, you can aim your pistol at them, and whether you want to believe this or not, I'd prefer the pistol compared to the stupid-ass weapons you pick up during the game. Now, the added feature of upgrading your arsenal, thankfully, was much better in the sequel, Elevator Action Returns, but that was 1994. The Game Boy version of this came out in 91. People just weren't thinking. Okay, not all the weapons are flawed. The grenades seriously screw you over worse than a hooker with hepatitis. You throw one, you gotta wait until it fully explodes to throw another one. What's the wait time for? If you got a whole freaking fanny pack full of these bad boys, throw two at a time, goddammit! Okay, that covers the dumb weapons. Let's talk about the levels. If you've played Elevator Action in the arcades before and on the NES, you'll remember that the levels are pretty much the same except for a change in color, the red doors moved a little bit, and certain hallways are blocked. In the Game Boy version, the layout has improved a great deal for just about every level. Some levels even start you in the middle of the building. Yeah, like on the 14th floor, and you gotta go up to find some documents, then make your way down. And look, there's some laundry chute action going on here. That's what it looks like to me. Someone email me and tell me what the hell this is. I think it's cool. It's a neat little shortcut. Now, for colorless Game Boy graphics, I'm actually looking at some good stuff here. Agent 17 looks to be animated better, the walking looks better, the jumping has improved, and check this out. You can jump down the shaft.
You're damn right.
Watch how you jump, though. Otherwise, this is a great way to get to where you're going without having to wait for those slow-ass elevators. Alright, now I've talked a little bit about how the game looks graphically. It's a nice improvement. The sound leaves you a bit cold, more so in the music department. I think they just took the original game's track and sped it up a bit. You will be hearing this in every single level. So as not to drive you crazy, let's spice up the music some. Maybe you can tolerate this better. The effects are nice and average, and besides hearing your pistol go off, you also got those useless weapons and their little noises. Control gives me a hard time every once in a while, but nothing really major that will stop you from getting far in the game. I got to level 6, I believe, and besides dealing with these guys in black who don't want you stealing their porn, there are also these attack dogs, and holy frickin' bloody hell, you got robot drones on one level. I haven't made it all the way through yet, but I'll be honest, there's no indication that I'll have to play the same amount of levels all over again. But even if I did, it's black and white. How the hell am I gonna know? It might have sounded like I was giving this game a bad rap, but I'm actually enjoying it so far. The game may not get everyone's attention, so if you're skeptical or spoiled, try it. Well, that's it for this review.